We recently added the REDARC BCDC Alpha100 R to our store, shop.EXPLORIST.life. And for every component that we make, we also make a wiring kit, so that kind of takes all the guesswork out of what wire size to use, what lug size to use, what fuse size to use, how many mounting screws do I need, what other little bits and pieces do I need to actually make this thing work. So in this video, I'm going to go over the wiring kit for the REDARC BCDC Alpha 100 R and show you how to wire it all together, as well as, you know, the parts that you need to do it as part of the EXPLORIST Life wiring kit. So let's get into it. We've got our components laid out right here. We've got our Victron Lynx distributor, which would be connected to our house battery bank. Remember, that's the battery bank we're charging. And then we're going to pretend that the alternator is off that direction, alternator and starting battery. We would be connecting to the starter battery or other appropriate connection point on the factory vehicle at that point. I've also got my wiring diagram here off to the side, which we can supply this to you if you're purchasing the wiring kit from us. And I have our wiring kit here. So we've got our positive wire and our negative wire. These wire sizes will change depending on the length of wire that you are getting in your kit. And so we'll just supply you the correct size of wire. So that's not something you have to figure out. In our shop.explorist.life hardware kit, we have our positive and negative wires for the REDARC unit, as well as the hardware kit, as well as the little informational thing that says to be on the lookout for these in the overall package. The two smaller wires, these are 4-gauge wires, and there's about 1 foot of black and about 2 feet of red, because the maximum wire size that you can put on the REDARC BCDC Alpha 100 R is 4-gauge, which is honestly a little bit of a pain considering you really need to use bigger wire to go up to the starter battery for the full 100 amp output. So we have to sort of drop this down to a more appropriate size to fit on these terminals here. So for the hardware kit, we have all the appropriate heat shrink, the appropriate fuse for the Lynx distributor over here, all of our appropriate wire lugs. Now, there are 3 different hole sizes of wire lugs. All these are 5/16 inch wire lugs, these are 1/4 inch wire lugs, and these are 3/8 inch wire lugs. So just refer to the wiring diagrams on which one goes to which, because they're all labeled. We've also got our parallel splice connectors for the drop down from the bigger wire down to the 4-gauge wire, and all of our mounting screws. The REDARC BCDC Alpha 100 R also comes with its own set of data cables, as well as its power wire that goes from the DC-to-DC charger to its own shunt, so it can provide some monitoring capabilities on its own. So first and foremost, I'm going to make the wires that connect to the REDARC BCDC Alpha 100 R. First, I'm gonna make the connections to the actual REDARC Alpha BCDC charger. Take my black wire, cut it to length, measure for my wire lug, crimp on my wire lug, heat shrink the connection, this side goes to the shunt, and we're going to repeat the process on the other side for the lug that goes to the REDARC charger. Now the wire from the REDARC BCDC charger to the shunt is made. Let's move on to the other wires before we connect all these up. Hey, just a heads up, all of this stuff that you're finding on this video, as well as this whole channel, is available in our store, shop.EXPLORIST.life. This entire channel at this point in time is funded entirely by purchases coming from our store. So if you're benefiting from this video, if you're enjoying the tutorials, if you're learning something new, consider purchasing from shop.EXPLORIST.life so that we can keep making these videos. We're priced the same as anywhere else you'll find online, including Amazon, and all of those proceeds go back to funding these videos. So, thanks for watching. Back to the video. Now, all of our battery lugs, our standard lugs like these, are crimped into place on all of our appropriate wires, both positive and negative, as well as the ones going off toward the starter battery, which would be all of these right over here. There's nothing different on any of this. It's all crimping wire lugs. The unique part about this particular kit is having to go from these smaller wires here to the bigger wires that are more appropriate to carry a full 100 amps from this device here to where it needs to go, as well as from where it's coming from. So we've got our wires stripped off on both sides. This side is going to go to this terminal here, and then we just need to make that junction here. Now, I kind of went back and forth on the best way to do this, but REDARC actually has some manufacturer's suggested recommendations, and it was to use a it's sort of like a butt splice connector. It's called a parallel splice is what it is. And it's just an oversized ferrule, if you will, or it's kind of realistically just the bottom part of a wire lug like this. And, you know, just with the top part cut off, it's really thick. So it's going to hold its shape. And the way we do this is we just simply put this stripped wire in on this side here, like so. And then put this side into it like so, keeping special care to make sure that there's no strands just hanging out. And then you just crimp this just the same as you do a standard wire lug. And that gives you just a really, really, really good connection between that smaller wire and that bigger wire there. It's not necessarily quite, you know, as pretty as a wire lug, but ultimately, like, you know, for, you know, our limitation of the 4-gauge on this side and everything on this side, you know, like, this is the best option, and it is a manufacturer suggested connection method. Now, as far as like what size of parallel splice connector to use, you don't have to worry about that, because we're just going to send you the right one when you buy your wiring kit. And once these have heat shrink on them, they clean up pretty nicely for the most part. Now, we are considering making all of this in a pre-crimped bundle so that you don't have to sort of, you know, buy this $150 crimper or anything like that. So let us know down in the comment section if you would want this in a pre-crimped version, if you would find that useful at all. So we're going to move on to connecting all these wires up to where they actually go. Negative wire to the negative bus bar of the Lynx distributor. Directly on the bus bar with no washer in between. Washer. Lock washer. Nut. We're gonna put the big end of the wire onto this lower stud of the Lynx distributor. Fuse directly on top of that. Notice that there is no washer in between the bus bar and the fuse, or the fuse and the wire lug. And then washers, lock washers, and these nuts. You will want to use a torque wrench on all of these connections to torque to the proper specs. My elbow actually clicks when I get to the proper spec, so I'm good to go here. Got a torque elbow. Don't come at me. And our Lynx distributor is now all wired up for these connections. Remember, this is what you would be getting power from and sending to your house or auxiliary batteries. Moving on to the REDARC connections right here. We have four right across the front. We have our solar connection. We're going to be ignoring that for this particular video because we're just showing the DC to DC charging functionality for this particular video. This part is coming from the car, which has got this little icon right on it. So that is going to be this wire here that's going off to the engine starting battery. And then our positive here is coming to the Lynx distributor. This is the direction of the primary charging. And then our negative here is going to go to our shunt. Now these wire lugs over here and these two wire ends, these would go over to your engine starting battery. And that's whenever you would crimp these ones here. Now, of course, if you purchase the pre-crimped version, they would already be on there and you'd just have to sort of coil your wires up somewhere nice and neat. But ultimately, these lugs over here are gonna go to your engine starting battery, just the same way as is in the diagram here. That's really hard to see. Just like this, and your breaker right here looks about like this. It's going to be installed at the starting battery, just the same as you've seen in any of our start to finish electrical system tutorials, but we're not going to show that in this video. We're just going to keep it focused to everything right in here. With the power wires all finished up, we're going to move on to the REDARC supplied data cables. The first is this REDARC battery sense lead, and that is going to go to the positive bus bar over here on the Lynx distributor, just like so. The other end goes into the battery monitor over on the side, only goes in one spot. We're not going to cover what specifically this does. This is more of a where to connect it. The user manual for this device here actually has a great explanation of what all this does. And if I haven't mentioned it already, this shunt does come with the REDARC BCDC charger. And that is pretty much that with all of our data cables and our wiring cables in place. Realistically, that's pretty much how you connect all of this. Now there's still wiring management to do. Still, you have to secure this down because, you know, we do supply mounting screws for all of these components with our wiring kits. You know, we already kind of pre-sized everything out so that there's no guesswork and you don't have to make trips back and forth to the hardware store. So that would be the next steps here, but ultimately this is my actual desk and I'm not going to put these screws into my actual desk. So in a real life situation, we'd secure all this up. And then we would also be securing all of our wires with wire clamps, strain relief to the backer board of whatever we're using or the enclosure. And that is pretty much that. So all in all, this is a pretty simple installation for the most part. It doesn't take very long. I'm not sure how long the camera was rolling, but I don't know, probably 20 minutes or so by somebody who kind of knows how to crimp wire. Keep in mind that we're going to be supplying this wiring kit both uncrimped as well as pre-crimped, or if you don't want to deal with it at all and you just want to drop it off with us, our installation shop is up in Bend, Oregon, and we are happy to help you out. So realistically, that's pretty much it. The wiring kit and the components are all available in our store, shop.exploris.life. So I hope this video was helpful. We'll see you in the next video.